Welcome back to Idtv. I'm Karen Jaffe, and today we are going to talk about the accreditation crisis at City College of San Francisco. Joining me in studio is CCSF Board Trustee Rafael Mandelman. Rafael, welcome to Idtv. And now, tell us about your connection to CCSF.
Well, Karen, I was elected to the Board of Trustees in November of 2012, which was an interesting time to be elected because it was just as the accreditation crisis had broken. I was sworn in January and served for about 6 months on the board before the ACCJC announced that it would be terminating City College's accreditation in 1 year. And at that point, the state chancellor suspended the local board. But since that time, although I haven't had a formal role on the board, I have continued to try to be an advocate for City College and to work to save it.
Well, what a pleasure to have you here with us today. I can tell that this is definitely going to be useful information for people. So let's get right down to it. Question on everybody's mind. Why is the City College of San Francisco in the position that it's in with regard to accreditation?
You know, it's a complicated combination of factors. So one thing that I really feel, and I don't know that everyone agrees, but I think that although City College is a fantastic institution that does amazing things for so many people, I think that it is true that in 2012, when the ACCJC came to visit, there were real problems at City College. There had been a 5-year recession, disinvestment in public education. There'd been trouble on the Board of Trustees with a lot of division. There were just some bad practices that had built up over time. There was nothing in the nature of corruption, and there was no one who was saying or who could say that City College was not providing a great education, but there were problems at City College. And I think everyone would have expected that the accreditor, the ACCJC, when they came to visit at that point for their for accreditation and to evaluate City College, that they would find some problems. Well, they didn't just find problems. They announced that they were putting City College on show cause, which is their highest level of sanction, and which means that the institution basically had 8 months to fix every problem they identified and to prove that it would have the ability or should have the right to continue, which was an incredible burden and test for the college.
Yeah, that's really a high hurdle to have to jump. I mean, that's amazing. That's actually some really useful background information on the whole story for me. But I have to wonder, what is the ACCJC, and how can they make such sweeping decisions that affect us?
It's a question that a lot of San Franciscans are asking, that a lot of Californians are asking right now. So for decades, community colleges, the public, our legislature has relied on our accrediting agencies to evaluate schools and basically say that they're providing a decent education, that they're worthy of funding. They perform an important function in that way. And they also provide an opportunity for schools to learn what, you know, areas where they need to improve. Now, over the last 5 to 10 years, the ACCJC, which is a private, non-governmental, largely unaccountable body, has become increasingly aggressive in terms of the sanctions it's been imposing and its willingness to threaten to close public institutions, community colleges. And I think that's where people like me think that they've gone wrong and where what's happened to City College has really been quite unfair and quite terrible.
Yeah, that just seems like they're kind of singling this out. That's not good at all. Now, I have to ask, who makes the day-to-day decisions about running CCSF, and like, who's planning for our future?
Right. So right now, there's the chancellor, a new chancellor. But instead of the Board of Trustees, the locally elected Board of Trustees, City College has a special trustee with extraordinary powers. So basically, that's one person who's been appointed by the state chancellor. His name is Bob Agrella right now, and I actually quite like Bob Agrella and think he's trying to do a good job. But that's an extraordinary concentration of authority in one person, and I think over time is actually not great for the institution.
Wow, that is a lot of power for one person. It's good that he's a good person.
He's a good person.
Right?
Yeah.
And it's always helpful to know that we've got other people pulling for us. Now, what kind of support is CCSF getting, like at the city and local and state and federal level even? Are we getting support?
We're getting a ton of support from all over. I think initially when bad things started happening in 2012 and even in 2013 when the ACCJC announced that it was actually going to be terminating our accreditation, there were some people who thought this really must be City College's fault and you know, weren't inclined to look at the problems with the ACCJC. I think that has changed. And so people from across the political spectrum, all the way up to Nancy Pelosi and Jackie Speier in Congress, have stepped forward and raised questions about the accreditor. The Department of Education has weighed in. Actually, there's a story in today's Chronicle saying that, basically with them saying that the ACCJC has the authority to extend the timeline for City College to prove it's worthy of accreditation, that they don't have to shut us down now. So there's been a lot of organizing in the state legislature, Assembly members Amiano and Bonta, in the state Senate, Leno and Bell and others have been playing a leading role. Everyone, including the mayor, have been fighting to try to save City College. And community colleges statewide, actually, academic senates throughout the state, AFT, American Federation of Teachers locals, boards of trustees have been passing resolutions expressing their support for City College and their concern and lack of faith in the ACCJC, at least as it's currently operating.
Wow, sounds like we've got some very powerful allies, definitely the people that we want on our side here in this fight.
It really is a fight.
But I believe so much in public education that I'm a big fan of it, needless to say. So let's hear from some of our allies right now. Our producer, Colby Michaels, got some reaction from local politicians, so let's take a look.
The biggest challenge has been enrollment, which is actually how, you know, schools are funded based on the number of students they have. And so the fact that there was this idea that City College was going to go under kept many people from signing up for City College and enrollment dropping precipitously. That has impacted also the students that are going, that are there, because there have been some choices that the administration has made, a payment policy that doesn't reflect the financial reality that students face on a daily basis, many students being forced out of enrollment because they can't afford to pay. You've also had cuts in student services. But I think in the end, the big challenge is that we are talking about an accrediting commission trying to change how City College works, trying to make it less community focused, trying to make it less student focused, and trying to change it into something that it has never been. You know, City College is really, in many respects, the heart of San Francisco. It's an institution that embodies what the city is about, and they're trying to change that about it.
I think I can speak for many other leaders in City Hall. I think we would strongly fight any revocation of City College's accreditation. That is not to the benefit of San Francisco for City College to lose its accreditation. And ultimately, this is about what's best for the people of San Francisco, and an accredited City College is part of that.
The economic impact on San Francisco if City College would close, it would be ginormous. Mostly City College is serving people who are seeking to get retrained for work, or a lot of people who are looking to get into higher education or to get trained into certain professions. And if that was taken away, you would lose a huge place where people can get that training, that education, and that would mostly affect working people in the city. Well, it's all part of the removal of working class people that's happening in San Francisco, whether it's planned or it's through negligence or indifference. We're seeing that happen, and if City College were to go away, it would accelerate that process. We would lose one of the institutions that has been working for our communities to be able to have greater opportunity for our future.
Now that was some good stuff. Now, you know, this is the pressing question everybody wants to know. What is the latest news in regards to our accreditation crisis or status? And what can the students and the public actually expect from us? Is CCSF going to stay in the education business?
CCSF is going to survive one way or another. In addition to all the other support we have, our city attorney has brought a lawsuit and has gotten an injunction to prevent the accreditor from being able to shut City College down until that lawsuit is heard. So that's great. I think the news from the Department of Education that I mentioned is also helpful. I think there are people, basically the ACCJC's decision to terminate our accreditation does not take effect until the end of July. And won't take effect even then because of the lawsuit. But until the end of July or the beginning of July, the ACCJC still can back down or back away from its decision. And I think there are a lot of people who hope they will, and there's a lot of work going on behind the scenes to encourage them to do that.
Excellent. Back off. It's us.
Yeah.
Well, that certainly sounds hopeful. That's what we're all thinking about. I would like to thank CCSF Board Trustee Rafael Mandelman for being our guest today here in the studio and for bringing us up to date on CCSF's accreditation crisis. As you heard, City College of San Francisco is open and taking registrations for upcoming summer and fall classes. Visit the link below to start registering today and to find out the latest with the accreditation crisis and to show your support for CCSF, go to the website address at the end of this show for more info. Thanks for watching IDTV.